He is the first skater to land a quad jump in competition, a feat that also landed him a world record. He's a four-time world champ, and if that wasn't enough, he's also been inducted into Canada's Walk of Fame. In case you haven't figured it out, I'm talking about the one and only Curt Browning. And though he's been out of the competitive life for 8 years now, he's still tearing up the rink, shining brightly in Stars on Ice. Curt joins us now from Lake Placid, New York. First of all, good morning, Curt. I've got to ask you, what's it like performing as a professional? I mean, you've been doing this for quite some time, huh?
Yeah, I'm getting a little long in the tooth. Yeah, this is getting on about my 13th or 14th year with Stars on Ice in Canada, and about my 8th year in Stars on Ice here in the United States. So if I don't know how to do this by now, I better look for another job.
Do you miss the competition, though? I mean, even though it's been this long?
You know, for the first 4 years as a pro, I did, and I had an opportunity to actually compete with the amateurs in what we called pro-am events. And now I'm kind of settling into the watching mode and maybe commentating and stuff. I don't compete as much as I used to.
So you're doing a lot of commentating now?
Something that might be happening in the future, but I'm still very busy with Stars on Ice. Obviously, we're, you know, HSNB Stars on Ice, and we're starting to get that rolling, get that excited, get people, get the word out, and we're here in Lake Placid, and this is where Stars on Ice in Canada actually starts. It starts down in the States. We tour for 3 months across the States, and then the show will move up into Canada. So we'll have it nice and oily and ready and good and settled for you guys.
So I was going to say, I like the sound of this. You're doing rehearsals, basically your extended rehearsals in the United States, so you know you're going to be in fighting form for the hardened crowd in Canada.
I like how you're thinking. 61 rehearsals across the United States getting ready for Canada.
That's right. Yeah, that's how it works. Okay, so you got Tara Lipinski, you've got Todd Eldridge, you've got Jamie Siley, David Pelletier. This must be great fun for you guys.
Oh, it is a lot of fun. It's like you said, I'm getting long in the tooth, we mentioned, and to get to skate with the guys who just not only skated at the Olympics but won the Olympics. You mentioned Jamie and David, who all Canadians love and worship. We also have the men's champion, a fantastic skater, Lexi Yagudin, will also be joining the cast. Tara Lipinski won't be with us. Our lady will be Jennifer Robinson, Canadian champion, and she was fantastic in Salt Lake City.
Yeah, wow. Let's talk about Siley and Pelletier. I mean, you stood there on the sidelines watching as all that happened. How are they holding up? I mean, have they changed altogether now that they're professionals? Have they managed to put it all behind them?
Well, it's one of those situations where, you know, small-town kids do well, and then, you know, David Letterman and Jay Leno, and their whole life just flipped upside down. They are great kids. They're very professional. I've been training with them now pretty consistently, 6 or 7 hours a day for a couple of weeks. Hardworking. I can see why they won. And, you know, they're just good Canadian kids. They want to be really good entertainers, and so they're looking forward to their career with Stars on Ice.
Did you ever pass any advice on to them?
Not really. I've known Jamie since she was 8, so I probably had some influence on her. And David, I'm just getting to know now. They're two people that really have their stuff together up here, and they're good friends. They're becoming really good friends. They don't need any advice from me.
Well, in the wake of that controversy now, new judging rules for skate competitions. Have the changes helped ease these controversies surrounding judging and figure skating? What do you think of them?
Not yet, because the rule changes are, you know, anytime you change anything, there's going to be some reluctance by somebody. Right now, the media is reluctant to have figure skating change because they want that bad judge to point a finger at. I'm hoping that the changes do work. I'm very optimistic. And then it'll get the attention back to what's important, which is called skating. And maybe that's especially what Jamie and David want to do. They want to stop talking about what happened and start talking about what's going to be happening. For example, HSBC Stars on Ice. And they want to get on with their career and start entertaining people.
One of the more controversial, let's talk briefly, you know, about some of the more controversial changes that have been made. One of them is a judge's anonymity and the fact that we won't be able to put a score onto a particular judge.
Yeah.
Do you agree with that decision?
Well, you know what it is? I did another interview and I said something about suppose that people just stopping at red lights and just kept going through it. Well, pretty soon the whole city would be in chaos and you'd have to have a policeman at every single stoplight in the city. That's what we have to do right now. Unfortunately, we have enough people who are, you know, trying to sidestep all the rules that worked for years. The 6.0 system worked. The judge from Germany giving a mark and the judge from France, it all worked. But when you're cheating, it doesn't work. So here we are, we're having to police the system. And this is one of the side effects of it. Is it gonna stay like this? Is it gonna work? Only time will tell. We haven't even fully implemented one competition with the new rules yet. But it's a necessity, unfortunately.
And a lot of people wonder, too, you know, with artistic interpretation, so many other things being as subjective as they are, you know, it might look... I mean, the changes are technical, obviously technical. There's a very subjective and very beautiful element to skating. I mean, is it possible to find a perfect system to judge it?
Your soft side is coming out. No, because people are involved. There is no such thing as a perfect system. You know, the 100-meter run, where it's just timed by computers, is about as perfect as you're going to get. Figure skating isn't perfect, which is also one of the fun things about it. Everybody's opinion's great. It's one of those sports that actually goes to the Olympics and then endures, for example, professional world, because it has much more to offer than just the idea of the sport. No, it's not going to be perfect, but, you know, I'm hoping that this system eases some of the tension. But people don't want to watch figure skating and not know that the guy who won was actually the guy that won.
Well, let's switch gears and talk about you for a second. I mean, your wife is a principal dancer with the National Ballet of Canada. You're on tour with Stars on Ice. How the heck do you guys even manage to see one another, especially at this crazy time of year?
It's just a lifestyle choice that you make, and a lot of people have to travel. I travel 6 to 8 months a year. That's going to change in the future, but it's... when you make a living with your knees and your back and your body, you really have to do it while you can, because once you leave, you don't really get to come back, so... But it's fun. I'm having the time of my life. It's fantastic to have this job. Like my dad says, you know, you're a lucky kid, because at the end of your workday, people clap. How many people get that?
That's an excellent way of putting it.
Yeah, dads have a way of keeping you under control.
Yeah, it's funny that. Are you going to see your family, or are you going to see your new wife on New Year's Eve? Are you going to spend any time together?
Yeah, I'll be with my wife on New Year's Eve, and Stars and Ice takes a break, and, you know, it is the Christmas season, so it's time to spend time with your family and do all those important things.
And would you care to say that your resolution would be to get more applause, even more?
Pardon me, my resolution? You're going to give one to me? Okay. I'm ready. It should be. My wife is Spanish, so I have to learn Spanish. So ask me in 5 years if I can speak Spanish.
Well, lastly, Stars on Ice, you know, all your friends there, I'm just wondering if you guys abide by the rule that what goes on the road stays on the road.
The road is a quirky place. I mean, I've known, for example, Isabel Bresser and Lloyd Eisler on the tour. And, you know, I've known these people since I was a young teenager. And we sort of, on the road is kind of like our college years. And we really, really worship this time and treasure it. And, you know, when we're in the show, it's a really special place. And when you're out of it, you're going to miss it badly. So we try to treasure it, especially as we're getting older.
Well, if these are your college years, sit back and have some fun. And I hope they're more productive than mine were.
I'll try and graduate.
Exactly. Thanks very much, Kurt.
Take care.